Hello, everyone. Meteorologist Mike Haddad here in the Storm Watch 9 Weather Center. Another weekend is here, but this one much different than the other ones we've had so far in this new year, as the first major statewide snowfall builds on in. As for the weak system that darted through on Friday, that's about to pull on out of here with the clouds breaking during the overnight and early on Saturday ahead of this storm. That's beginning to take shape. Quite a bit of energy rotating out of the southern Rockies into the southern plains. Moisture here as well. And this all builds in our direction starting Saturday evening and lasting through early afternoon on Sunday. Even when the storm departs, we're going to have the after effects of some very strong winds and bitterly cold, dangerous wind chills for Sunday night through early on Tuesday. So again, clouds break overnight tonight. A little bit of partial sun gives way to increasing clouds on your Saturday. And sometime after about 3-4 o'clock, there could be a few flurries. Then some steady light snow breaks out from 5 to 7 p.m. Then that snow becomes more widespread and increases in intensity very late in the evening and especially overnight into early on Sunday. These deep shades of blue indicate a potential for snowfall rates to exceed 1 inch or 1.5 inches per hour. We could see 2 inches per hour for a few hours during the pre-dawn hours of Sunday through about late morning. Also during that time, we'll be tracking warmer air that may result in a changeover to some sleet and freezing rain in extreme southeastern parts of the state, but a good part of the storm will be snow, and it's all out of here by the early to mid-afternoon, but gusty winds follow, blowing and drifting snow into Sunday night and Monday. Expected snow tallies, not much of a change to the forecast over the last couple of days. A general 12 to 20 inch snowfall statewide. Could see some lower amounts just to the south and east, especially near shore roads, and also in some of the favored shadowed areas of Coos in northwestern Grafton County. The winds, again, blow and drift the snow around from Sunday right through Sunday night and early on Monday. Some of those gusts could exceed 35 to 40 miles per hour, especially in southeastern New Hampshire, where there could be a few scattered power outages. In addition to that, we're also going to have the issue of minor coastal flooding Sunday morning due to a high astronomical tide and an onshore wind. But again, by midday and afternoon, the winds turn around to the northwest, driving the ocean waters away and diminishing the flood threat for later Sunday evening into the day on Monday. A lot of bitter cold again builds in behind the storm, with wind chills well below zero statewide Sunday afternoon through Monday night and early on Tuesday.